Hello and very warm welcome to 3.0 TV. I'm your news host Parvati Nirban, and Crypto TV has rebranded itself as 3.0 TV to provide an all-round update to viewers and help broaden the understanding of the evolving digital segment, including cryptocurrencies, blockchain projects, metaverse, non-fungible tokens, cybersecurity, and several other related issues. Keep watching 3.0 TV for all things related to Web3, including to keep abreast of all the ongoing happenings and transformation in the digital space. Let's get into the world of crypto with English News Bulletin. Let's have a look at the headlines first. WazirX parent says crypto exchange compliant with India KYC rules. Cryptocurrencies fall in tandem with stocks. Bitcoin slips below $23,000. Crypto intelligence platform Messari plans to raise $35 million at $300 million valuation. Andreessen Horowitz leads to $20 million funding round for Creator DAO. Blockchain analysis platform Merkle Science raises $19 million. Hacker returns crypto worth $32.6 million to Nomad Bridge. Reddit expand community points offering with FTX Pay integration. Anonymous user trolls celebrities by sending ETH from Tornado Cash. Zenmai Labs Private, the holding company which is owned by Indian cryptocurrency exchange WazirX, has claimed that its local entity is full compliant with the Know Your Customer norms laid down by the regulators and Indian laws. In a statement, while maintaining that WazirX is operated jointly by the holding company and Binance, Zenmai said it has fully cooperated with the ED for several days and responded to its queries transparently. The holding company claimed that the ED seems to be investigating the transactions of certain users, and Zenmai Lab has no affiliation to such users and is unaware about the purpose of their transactions. It claimed that it was a victim of misuse by some intermediaries. Additionally, it claimed that any off-chain transaction by customers could be done only with accounts that were fully KYC compliant. KYC details are available for all off-chain transfers as well and have been submitted to ED when requested. Off-chain withdrawals also cannot happen if the accounts are not KYC'd, Zenmai claimed. However, despite Zenmai Lab shifting the onus of compliance onto users, WazirX users have been loudly complaining that they aren't able to withdraw funds. Cryptocurrencies declined, mirroring the moves of key US stock market indices ahead of the release of inflation data later in the day. Bitcoin slipped below $23,000. At the close of Dow Jones Industrial Average lost 0.18%, while the S&P 500 index lost 0.42%. The Nasdaq Composite Index declined 1.19%. Investors are awaiting the latest reading of the July Consumer Price Index due later today. The report is expected to show a slight slowdown in inflation, thanks in part to fall in oil prices, which could inform the market about the next steps for the Federal Reserve. The inflation report will provide clues about how aggressive the Federal Reserve will need to be in its fight against inflation. Bitcoin was recently seen trading at around $22,890, down over 3.8% in the past 24 hours. ETH, the second biggest cryptocurrency, traded at around $1,680, down nearly 5% in the similar time span. All other major altcoins too traded lower. New York City-based crypto intelligence platform Messari plans to raise $35 million in financing at $300 million valuation. Messari raised $21 million in an August 2021 round led by hedge fund billionaire Steve Cohen's 0.72 Ventures. The round was raised at a post-money valuation of $100 million. Last week, the firm acquired crypto fundraising data provider Dow Metrics for an undisclosed amount. CreatorDAO, a decentralized autonomous organization that provides capital and operational support to creators, raised $20 billion in a seed funding round that was led by Andreessen Horowitz and Initialized Capital. CreatorDAO invests in creators in exchange for a percentage of their future earnings, the release said. The DAO structure allows investment decisions to be crowdsourced and the contribution to the DAO, such as mentorship and collaboration, to be rewarded. Entertainers such as Paris Hilton and musicians The Chainsmokers participated in the funding round and have agreed to share their time and expertise with the CreatorDAO community. Merkle Science, a predictive blockchain analyst platform, has added $19 million to its Series A funding round. The amount brings the total funds raised in the round to more than $24 million at an undisclosed valuation. The capital will help Merkle expand in the US and fund research and development for forensics analytics tool for emerging technologies such as decentralized finance, an area where Merkle is seeing interest among institutional investors and cross-chain bridge protocols. The funding extension was co-led by tech-focused venture capital firm Beko Capital, Darrow Holdings, and K3 Ventures. Merkle raised additional fund to invest more in technology and market expansion. The alleged hacker of the Nomad Bridge attack that occurred recently has returned $32.6 million worth of tokens within a few hours of Nomad publishing an Ethereum wallet address calling for the return of its stolen crypto assets. Last week, Nomad lost $190 million worth of crypto assets through a security vulnerability in its Ethereum-based cross-chain bridge. Along with some altcoins, most of the returned funds comprise Tether, USD Coin, and Frax. Social media giant Reddit has formed a partnership with FTX Pay to allow users to pay gas fees on transactions using community points. The integration will also allow Reddit users to purchase Ether directly on the app in order to pay for network fees on different blockchains. We are excited to partner with Reddit to continue their work to empower online communities to harness the power of blockchain, FTX CEO Sam Bankman-Fried said in the release. Reddit's move mirrored rival social media platform Twitter's approach, which integrated a blockchain reward system by introducing a Bitcoin tipping feature earlier this year. An anonymous user sent a slew of Tornado Cash transactions to high-profile Ethereum addresses on Tuesday in what appears to be a troll, implicating them in a potential regulatory mess. Affected wallets include those controlled by Coinbase CEO Brian Armstrong, TV host Jimmy Fallon, clothing brand Puma, and a wallet created for donations to Ukraine. Prominent crypto figures such as artist Beeple and more mainstream celebrities such as comedian Dave Chappelle receive Ether. The Treasury Department Office of Foreign Asset Control, a watchdog agency of the US government, sanctioned Tornado Cash on Monday, prohibiting US person and entities from interacting or transacting with the privacy tool. That's all for today's news. For daily news and updates of Crypto World, don't forget to watch English News Bulletin twice a day, only on 3.0 TV. For more such updates, latest stories and news podcasts, don't forget to like, share, comment and subscribe 3.0 TV on YouTube, Instagram, Facebook and Twitter. I'm your news host Parvati Narvan, signing off for now. See you tomorrow and have a wonderful day.